Hello everyone, how are you? So today we are going to discuss one of the most important topic of physics, current electricity. So let us try to understand it. First of all, you see, as what is this? You see, as the potential difference increases, the value of current also increases. Here, potential difference decreases, the value of current also decreases. So, the value of current increases as the potential difference across the terminal of the conductor increases, right? Now you see, keeping this resistance constant, as there is any change in resistance, there is a change in current. You see, as the value of resistance increases, the value of current decreases, right? Means there is a relationship between potential difference and current. Whenever we are supplying a potential difference across the terminal of the conductor, right, there is a current, and the value of current depends upon the potential difference applied across the terminal of the conductor, right. So, the current flowing through a conductor depends upon the value of potential difference applied across the terminal of the conductor, and which we call the Ohm's law. So, let us try to understand what is this Ohm's law. What is this Ohm's law? If we consider any conductor, you see Ohm's law. One of the fundamental law of current electricity. Fundamental law of current electricity. So, you have to understand this Ohm's law as it is playing one of the major role. So, try to understand what is this Ohm's law. If we consider any conductor, large number of free electrons are there, and are randomly moving in all direction. These electrons are randomly moving in all direction within the conductor. If we consider any conductor, the free electrons are randomly moving in all directions within the conductor. There is no potential difference between the two points. Suppose this is A point, this is B point. And VA is equal to VV, potential at A is equal to potential at V. There is no potential difference, there is no current, value of I is 0. So, the very simple thing, if we consider a conductor, free electrons are there and are randomly moving in all directions, the potential difference across the terminal of the conductor is 0. And so, current is also 0. There is no potential difference, no current. Means, there is a relationship between current and potential difference. So, let us try to find the relationship between potential difference and current. Now, if we apply a potential difference across the terminal of the conductor, like this. A cell is connected. As the cell is connected, this free electron starts moving towards the positive terminal, and due to which free electrons start moving along this direction, and so the conventional current flows along this direction. Electrons start moving from the lower potential towards the higher potential, that is towards the positive potential. As all of we know, electrons are negatively charged and this positive plate where deficiency of electrons are there, so electron starts moving from B to A, while the conventional current starts moving flowing from A to B. So as there is a potential difference across the terminal of the conductor, there is a current, right? So the value of current depends upon the potential difference applied across the terminal of the conductor. Means the value I directly proportional to the potential difference applied across the terminal of the conductor, right? Or V is equal to IR. V is equal to IR, where R is known as resistance of the conductor. Abhi tak maine statement nahi bola. Just I am telling that there is a relationship between I and V, and I is directly proportional to V, or V is equal to IR, where R is a constant of proportionality. Constant of proportionality. And its value depends upon temperature, strain, pressure, humidity, etc. That is, electric current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the difference of potential between the two terminals of the conductor, provided the other physical conditions like temperature, pressure, humidity or strain of the conductor will remain same, will remain constant. So I repeat it again, electric current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the difference of potential difference applied across the terminal of the conductor, provided the temperature and other physical conditions like temperature, strain, pressure, humidity or etc. will remain constant, right? Now we see why I am introducing this temperature, strain, pressure, humidity, etc. See, so these electrons are moving along this like that, randomly moving along like that, right? Once there is a potential difference, I'm rubbing this one, remove this, okay. Now as there is a potential difference applied across the terminal of the conductor, so electrons start moving along this direction. Now it depends, the motion of the electron and hence the flow of the current depends upon the temperature of the conductor, because temperature on temperature depends upon the relaxation time and hence drift velocity, already I discussed in other class also. So the thing is that as the temperature increases, relaxation time, drift velocity, etc. will change, and due to which R will change, depends upon pressure, length, humidity, etc. I will discuss later also. So the thing is that just now try to understand the statement, and after that I will explain all these things, all these factors also. So according to Ohm's law, I is proportional to V, current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the applied potential difference, right? Provided this will remain constant. Means if we draw a graph between I and V, if we draw the graph between I and V, it should be a straight line, linear relation. As voltage increases,
current increases. Voltage increases, current increases. Voltage increases, current increases. That is, R will remain constant. R is constant, right? R is constant. R is constant. Now, it is not necessary that always the graph between I and V is linear. Those conductor which obeys this graph between V and I are known as ohmic conductor, and those would not obey this Ohm's law, this graph, are known as non-ohmic conductor. Jaise ki for some good conductor also, the graph between I and V is not a linear graph. Here is the linear graph. For some good conductors, the relation between I and V is not a linear relation. Ohm's law would not valid. For semiconductor, for diode, for transistor, this Ohm's law would not valid. There is a no linear relationship between this is V, this is I, the graph is like that. There is no linear relationship between V and I. Means in every case Ohm's law is not valid. Ohm's law, those which conductor obeys Ohm's law are known as ohmic, and rest are non-ohmic conductor. Correct? Understand Ohm's law? Okay. Chalo. Now, these are the limitations. Limitations to sabka hi hota hai. So, bahut sare teacher kehte hai ki proof of Ohm's law. Dekho, law ka koi proof nahi hota. Newton's law ka proof nahi hota. वो वैलिड है या नहीं वो चेक कर सकते हम. तो लेट अस चेक द वैलिडिटी ऑफ Ohm's law. दिस Ohm's law, वेदर इट इज वैलिड और नॉट, वी मे चेक इट. सो लेट अस चेक इट. लेट अस चेक इट. वैलिडिटी of Ohm's law. Ya valid hai ya nahi hai, validity of Ohm's law. Right? Ohm's law ka validity dekhte hai, chaliye. So, you know, drift velocity, what is drift velocity? Drift velocity, Vd is equal to minus E tau by m. In magnitude form, in scalar form likhe to E tau by m. Only magnitude I am writing. Okay. Or Vd or E is equal to, okay. Wait. Or Vd is equal to E tau by m. E is equal to, what is E? E is equal to V by L. You know V by L. B is the potential difference applied across the B. So V by L is equal to V by L. Electric field is equal to potential difference divided by the length, right? So, or again, I is equal to, okay, chalo, do one thing. Or V is equal to ML Vd by E tau.
ओके ना, और बी इक्वल टू एम एल ई टाउ वी डी, वी इक्वल टू आई इक्वल टू एनी ए वी डी, यू नो आई इक्वल टू एनी ए वी डी पता है ना, देन वी डी इक्वल टू क्या है आई वाई एन ई ए राइट, और वी इक्वल टू एम एल वाई एन ई स्क्वायर ए टाउ आई करेक्ट, रिमूव दिस वन, और वी इक्वल टू एम मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, हियर यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड here you have to understand m mass of electron l length of conductor n charge density ya electron density e charge of electron A, area of cross section, right? Now we see mass of electron and charge of electron will remain same, but length of conductor, charge of electron will remain same. Now length of conductor, area of cross section of the conductor depends upon the nature of the material. That is, it depends upon the pressure. It depends upon the strain. Also, you may strain depends upon the temperature of the conductor. So, temperature on the conductor. So, these factors will remain constant. Mass L, N, E, and A will only constant whenever temperature is constant. Whenever the strain is constant. Whenever pressure is constant, whenever humidity is constant. So this term is only constant whenever we will satisfy these conditions. And so in Ohm's law, it is very much important to say that yes, I is proportional to B, but only when the temperature, pressure, humidity, etc. will remain constant. Right, or V is equal to R I, or V is equal to I R. Wow, V is equal to V is equal to I R. Right, V is equal to I. Here R is known as resistance of the conductor, right? And it depends upon the nature of the material. It depends upon temperature, right? So this is the expression for R is ML by N e square A. You may also consider it. So this is your Ohm's law. Yes, Ohm's law obvious this concept of drift velocity, and from the concept of drift velocity we have obtained our Ohm's law, correct? So chalo, now generally this is the scalar form, this is the scalar form, because V potential difference is a scalar quantity, I is a scalar quantity, R is also a scalar quantity. Many times student may ask that why sir I is a scalar quantity, I to vector quantity ho sakte hai, to why I is a scalar quantity, dekho try to understand why I is considered a scalar quantity. Ye dekho current aaya, current idhar gaya idhar gaya, mera paas 5 ampere tha, 2 ampere in this direction, then obviously 3 ampere in this direction, kya ye angle change karne se एंगल का वैल्यू 20 डिग्री, तो जो वैल्यू आएगा क्या मैं 30 डिग्री करने से चेंज होगा, क्या मैं 60 डिग्री करने से चेंज होगा, क्या मैं इसको 90 डिग्री बनाने से चेंज होगा? नहीं ना, दैट इज एवरी टाइम द वैल्यू इज 2 एम्पियर एंड 3 एम्पियर विल रिमेन सेम, इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ एंगल. अगर इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ एंगल है तो मेरे तो वी नो दैट वेक्टर एडिशन रूल व्हेयर आर इज इक्वल टू रिजल्टेंट इज इक्वल टू रूट ऑफ आर पी स्क्वायर प्लस क्यू स्क्वायर प्लस ट्वाइस पी क्यू कॉस थीटा. अभी एंगल का ऊपर डिपेंड है ही नहीं सम, तो इट कैसे होगा? ये वेक्टर एडिशन रूल फॉलो नहीं कर रहे करंट वेक्टर एडिशन रूल फॉलो नहीं कर रहे. अकॉर्डिंग टू केसीएल जितना करंट इनकमिंग है उतना ही आउटगोइंग हो रहा है, वहां पर कोई भी किरचॉफ्स करंट लो कोई भी एंगल का ऊपर डिपेंड नहीं कर रहे. अगर तुम 90 डिग्री बना दो तो क्या इधर 3 एम्पियर से 4 एम्पियर बन जाएंगे? नहीं ना, तो एंगल का ऊपर डिपेंड नहीं कर रहे. एंड सो करंट इज प्योरली अ स्केलर क्वांटिटी. मतलब मीन्स व्हाट? मीन्स वी रियल टू आयर जो था ना, ये स्केलर फॉर्म है. वी रियल टू आयर इज योर स्केलर फॉर्म, राइट? नाउ ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द वेक्टर फॉर्म. चलो व्हाट इज इट्स वेक्टर फॉर्म? वेक्टर फॉर्म ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी BD is equal to E tau by M. Just I have written here the scalar magnitude form, right? Drift velocity BD is equal to E tau by M. Now we know R is equal to MVD by. अच्छा one thing you see, V is equal to IR. इसको स्केलर फॉर्म में से वेक्टर फॉर्म होगा ये कैसे मुझे समझ में आया? यू नो पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस का जो सोर्स है ये है इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड जो एक वेक्टर क्वांटिटी है. करंट का जो सोर्स है वो करंट डेंसिटी है वो भी वेक्टर क्वांटिटी है. दोनों ये स्केलर का सोर्स वेक्टर ही है. मतलब ये दोनों में अगर रिलेशन है तो ऑब्वियसली ये दोनों में भी रिलेशन होगा, राइट? एंड आवर एम इज टू फाइंड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ई एंड जे. एंड इफ इट इज पॉसिबल फॉर अस टू फाइंड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ई एंड जे मीन्स इट इज द वेक्टर फॉर्म ऑफ ओम्स लॉ, करेक्ट? चलो सो वी वांट टू फाइंड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ई एंड जे. यस तो चलो इसका खलास करते हैं. एम वी डी बाई ईटा इज इक्वल टू एम वी डी बाई ईटा. नाउ यू नो बी इज इक्वल टू आई आर ऑलरेडी वी नो दैट V is equal to IR. Okay, V is equal to क्या है? EL. क्योंकि E is equal to B by L, तो V is equal to EL equal to IR. Okay ना? अब E equal to क्या है? MVD by eta equal to IR. Correct ना? In place of E, मैंने बैठा दिया MVD by eta, right? IR. अभी देखो. और एम वी डी बाई ई टाओ आई का जगह में क्या लिखे? एन ई ए वी डी आर रख दो. अभी तो कैंसिल जाएगा, वी डी कैंसिल, राइट ना? अभी क्या है? वी डी कैंसिल हो गया तो रह गया क्या? एम बाई टाओ एन स्क्वायर
AR. Right. Let me see. Here you know we have to obtain E. Okay, let us keep E, no issue. Wait. It will be easier for you. One thing. One second. Let us do it in another way. It will be very simple for us. Okay. Chalo. Keep it like that. Or E L. What is I? N E A. Okay. Let us put I in like that. More easier. What is I? I is equal to current density in terms of current density. J is equal to current density. J is equal to kya hai? I by A. Current density J is equal to kya hai? I by A. Then we have to express in terms of I by A. Okay, I is equal to rho L by A. It will be easier for you. Very simple. In this way. Na jhamela, na janjat. Quickly ho jayege. E is equal to E L. Okay, E L is equal to I rho. Wait. E equal to I by rho L L cancel I by A rho. I by A rho L L cancel. Or E is equal to I by rho. What is I by A? I by A is J rho. Right? Oh yeah. J is equal to I by A. Or E vector is equal to J vector rho. Yes. E vector is equal to J vector rho. This is the relationship between electric field and current density. And is known as the vector form. Very simple. Simply do it like this. Earlier method is little bit longer, and so follow this method. So this is the vector form of Ohm's law. Ohm's law in vector form: electric field vector is equal to current density vector into rho vector. As current density, you know, current density already I discussed in other class. Current density J is equal to electric current per unit area perpendicular to the direction of the flow of the current. Right? So Ohm's law in scalar form, Ohm's law in vector form, and we also discussed some limitations of Ohm's law, okay, and validity of Ohm's law. Thank you very much for listening to me. Bye bye.